Hi everyone, welcome to Loving Life or victoriapaikin.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make this perfect shepherd's pie. So without further ado, let's get started.
Reheat skillet. To the skillet add oil. I'm adding avocado oil, this one. Well, I'm adding onion. This is pretty big one onion. You know, I'm not going to do it finely chopped. I love this because it was like poor man food. So I'm adding quite a lot and quite a big chunk. My grandmother told me that if you want a lot of flavor, caramelize your onion very well. Let it get golden, as you see here. Now, when it started to get golden, add carrot. Again, roughly chopped carrot will make all the difference. And again, in order it to be very sweet, try to caramelize it a bit, at least on one side of the carrot. So it can take a little bit of time. On this side, I placed potato. So this is 2.5 pounds of potato to boil in salted water. Always boil your potato from cold water. Place the potato in cold water, then add salt, and then boil it. So now it's bringing to a boil, it's warming up nicely, and I've added a bit salt to the water.
I'm using its spring lamb from New Zealand. This one, really nice. It was frozen, I defrosted it. And you need to know that in New Zealand there is a law that all lamb is grass-fed. In Australia, not so much. About 2/3 of the lambs are grass-fed. The rest can be fed if they have a more demanded supply. So if you like grass-fed, go for New Zealand. Carrot and onion already started quite caramelization. Beautiful one. This is the flavor that it will go long way later. So to this, totally add the beef. It's not a beef, sorry, it's a lamb. The lamb. And do this. Now lower the heat at this point. Because up to now it was on medium high. Now we're going to add the flavorings. This is Worcestershire sauce, as you see here. This is classical adding to, you know, flavoring. This is from Kirkland, as you see. It's no salt organic seasoning. As you can see here, this onion, garlic, carrots, black pepper, bell pepper, tomatoes, parsley and other bay leaves and other blend of really nice spices, by the way. It smells really good here. So about tablespoon of this one. It's really nice. Okay, this is not for flavor. It's but for the health benefit. This is turmeric. I'm adding just a pinch, like really tiny bit. And this one for more health benefit than anything else. And because we have black pepper in the seasoning, it will work beautifully. And if you don't know, when you mixed up turmeric and black pepper, its turmeric powers upgraded by 2,000 times. It becomes more powerful. So even this amount of turmeric can help immensely. So it's become, you know, health food as well, not just food. And I'm a big believer in food as a medicine. And this is how it's done. That's it. Mix it in. And I think our filling is pretty much done. It's wonderful. It smells really good in here, like awesome. It's poem. It's already done. And the last but not least needs to be by recipe is frozen peas, about cup and a half. Now here I don't have frozen peas. I was sure I have one, so I forgot to buy. But I have beans, so I just pre-cut most of the beans I see, not all of them, apparently, for smaller, you know, pieces, and I'm adding them in. And that's it. Close the heat. It was frozen before. And don't worry if the meat is not done yet, because it's going to be cooked again. So I bet it's done. It's almost done, but you know. That's it. Take large oven safe dish. This is 22 by 33 centimeters. It's pretty big. In inch, I don't remember how much it is inch, but it's pretty big because I want it spacious and I want room for my potatoes on top. Okay. Oh my God, it smells so good. You have no idea how good it smells. I wish it was smell-o-vision. Awesome. Excellent. And dispose it evenly on the bottom. This is potatoes that they're boiled and drained. Now to them I'm adding butter, obviously. It's a good one. We love quite a lot of butter. But I'm not going to add all stick of butter there. Now, to this I'm adding salt. Again, if you ask me why I'm using my hands, because I used to feel the amount of salt that I'm putting my food. I don't feel if I'm using salt shaker. I have no idea how much salt I put in. Black pepper, obviously. And mix it together. That I'm adding that are not regular. One huge garlic cloves. This is new garlic cloves. So it's at least like three normal ones. Now, you know, we really love our garlic in this family. So it's always bonus. At this point, you can add a little bit, about quarter to half cup of milk. Instead of milk, I love to add, this will be wonderful, yogurt, plain yogurt. Greek yogurt is good there, sour cream if you don't have yogurt. This yogurt I'm going to add about third to half cup of yogurt. This one is really good. I'm using this yogurt. I think if you see my recipe lately, you know about this yogurt very well. Mix it together. Now, this looks so good. All of this. Now I'm adding the potato on top of my filling. Again, we love a lot of potatoes. So there are people that don't like as much as potatoes as we love. It's nice, garlicky, and smells wonderful. Ariel, do you want a little bit of potatoes? Okay, all of potatoes, rather most of the potatoes is here. I left a little bit because Ariel asked me to leave for him just mashed potato. But rather than that, all the potatoes should go inside. It looks amazing right now. This cloud of goodness. Yeah, and another layer, again, it's not by any means necessary or even needed, but it's really good. I'm added cheese on top and it's become even cheesier. So this one is absolutely up to you. It's not in the recipe by any means, but this layer makes all the difference, I think. It's become cheesy, and as you know, mashed potato with cheese is awesome by itself, and on top it becomes layers of just goodness. It's now cheesy, covered with the cheese. This pop it to preheated oven to 375 degree, and for about 45 minutes or until all the cheese on top is melting ooey gooey and get a little bit of color, and then you know that it will be just perfect. I hope you will give it a go, and if you do, let me know in comments below or on Instagram and tag Victoria Paikin, tag me in there that I will see them. It was absolutely amazing. So as usual, don't forget to subscribe, write us a comment, thumbs up us, and cheers, loving life. See you next time.